The scenario is The Experiment, written for Harpoon 3 and the player's database. We'll take a moment to rearrange the map windows in order to maximize the efficiency of the game user interface. With the game on pause, we will examine the scenario background. And our current orders. We've been assigned two submarines, each with their own patrol zones, and must be on station for 14 hours. We have a Sierra 1 class submarine, and she's assigned to this patrol zone. We'll proceed at cruise speed and maximum depth. As well, we have a Victor 3 submarine and assigned to this patrol zone, which we will approach in the same manner. And we'll start the scenario. We'll set for any new contacts to be notified and increase the time compression. Once the Victor has entered her patrol zone, she's going to slow down to creep speed and simply patrol within her assigned area for 14 hours, starting now. Oh, and a subcontact has been detected, so we'll slow down compression. And immediately we're going to try to get a little separation in order to classify this contact. We're trying to get a cross bearing on it. Hopefully we can classify or get a range of the contact, but she sounds pretty close. I would guess she's within direct path range. That would make her under 15 miles or so. We're going to cut back and forth, hopefully run a target motion analysis by getting more triangulation on the contact. Hopefully we can get many different fixes, but she seems to be pretty quiet and we aren't getting any closer. In fact, we seem to be losing the contact. So we are running very deep in order to minimize our acoustic signature, but I'm going to come up to shallow depth. Perhaps she's running above the layer. The layer is a thermocline layer, which is a difference between the warmer surface water and the colder, deeper water. This tends to reflect the sound from contacts above the layer, and sound and contacts below the layer tend to have their sound reflected back down. So acts like a little shield between the surface and the deeper waters. No, it doesn't seem as though we're having much luck. Oh, okay, she just clarified the contact very quickly there. So we're gonna go back down deep. She sounds really, really close. And she's creeping around at 5 knots. So, she's well within range. We're going to check. Yes, our anti-submarine range. She's well within range. So anything creeping around at this distance is most likely going to be hostile. So we're going to engage with a pair of torpedoes. At the same time, we're going to be moving away and increasing speed to, we've already revealed our presence, so we may as well try to increase the range to the target. Hopefully our torpedoes will arrive and kill the enemy submarine before she gets a track on us and returns fire. Now, at this range, we still have a data link, which means we have a wire control guidance towards the to our torpedoes. So we're going to order them to activate their sonar, at least one of them. And activate. There we go. And it's going to feed us information, and we can feed it information. And two hits. We registered two explosions. So this submarine is most likely sunk. Whatever it is, it's now most likely dead. So we'll creep back towards it into our patrol zone. And we'll send off a contact report to theater headquarters reporting the destruction, probable destruction of a enemy submarine. And we sailed right through her last known position and lost contact. So we can, with a high degree of confidence, we report a NATO submarine destroyed. Class unknown. And the Sierra 1 arrives in her patrol zone and will patrol for 14 hours for any other NATO submarines that might appear. Oh, and we've detected another submarine. Oh, this one's already fired on us. So, okay, the torpedo is detected by both submarines. The Victor, oh my goodness, she's running fairly fast. So she could have drawn fire, but the Sierra is closest, and she's within torpedo range. So at this point, she already knows where we are. We're going to return fire with a pair of torpedoes. We're going to go sonar active because the enemy already knows where we are. We're not giving away any information by trying to remain stealthy. We'll go active with sonar. We'll try to lock her up before we evade. Nope, she's not within sonar. Oh, it's a tiger fish. And now that we've got our torpedoes in the water, we'll order them active as well, and we will run. Time to evade. Tigerfish are moving at 35 knots. We can also do 35 knots, so we should be able, and they aren't able to cut us off. Now the Victor is going to increase speed. It doesn't look as though she's the selected target, but she can't ignore a torpedo in the water either. Ah, there we go. And we're getting feedback from the wire guidance provided by our torpedoes, and they've locked onto a Goblin. This most likely is a British submarine, because only the British submarines carry tiger fish. We don't have a very good track on where the torpedo, if this is where the torpedo's coming from, we're going to change course and try to relocate that torpedo. But if it's going at 35 knots, it's unlikely it will be able to catch us. And we registered an explosion and a hit on the enemy submarine. Now we just have to evade this last threat. And we've done so. We can return to our patrol area and resume our patrol zone. That's two NATO subs destroyed, and we'll return back to passive sonar. And victory is granted. We were ordered to either destroy two submarines or be on station for 14 hours. And since we've completed and protected our submarines from destruction, victory. The submarines, we fired four torpedoes at them. We expended two decoys when they fired back at us. And we claimed a Sturgeon and a Trafalgar class nuclear submarines. This concludes the experiment written for Harpoon 3 and the Player's Database.